Hi, I'm Randy Geyer. This is my 1960 Plymouth Fury convertible. It's undergone a full rotisserie restoration. It's painted a factory color of caramel with cream colored coves and top. The wire wheels were an option. It has swivel seats. The swivel seats were touted by Chrysler as so a lady could maintain her dignity during ingress and egress. It also works for guys that are a little chubby, get in and out of there. Notice the square steering wheel? That was an option on those cars. The standard steering wheel was round. They called it the aero steering wheel, like A-E-R-O. It has embossed seats. Beautiful fabric. These door panels were also an option. These, I like to call them the puffy door panels in that they're three-dimensional. This part bulges out, if you can see that on the film. You could also, as the standard offering, it was the same pattern, but it was just flat, a little less expensive door panels. This car has an engine in that's called SonoRamic Commando Power. And what that means is that it's a big block engine with cross rams and two four-barrel carburetors at the outside of the fenders. This is a 383 cubic inch, 330 horse, and for Plymouth, that was the biggest engine you could get in this car for 1960. The other option on here, this fake spare tire cover, people refer to as the toilet seat. But that was also an option. That's an add-on piece that's bolted on top of the trunk lid. This car was rescued from a junk pile that was just about to get bulldozed into the earth when we pulled it out of the junk pile. It took four cars that we took parts and pieces and cut them up to put this all together to make one car out of. For 1960, Plymouth built about just over 7,000 Fury convertibles. The price tag on this car was very close to $3,000, $2,900 and some odd change. It is a powerful car. It's fun to drive. I like to take it and compete nationally with it in events such as AACA and these type of judged events and compete for awards for the quality of the car. This car I just finished restoring about 2 weeks ago, so it has yet to compete other than here at the 10,000 Lakes Concours d'Elegance.